Well, you've joined me today at the simply awesome Staunton Harold Reservoir. What a place this is. It's absolutely beautiful. I can't believe I've been on this planet 30 odd years and haven't come to this place. It's absolutely fantastic. So I'm really looking forward to a day's fishing here today. Now, the reason I brought you here today is because there's a lot of these sort of reservoirs across the country. Tamar, Bow Beach, Ferry Meadows, all these sort of places, big expanses of water with lots of fish in. Roach, pommies, perch, skimmers, and probably the main target for a lot of people is bream. So I know there's a lot of fish in here today and I'm hopefully going to get a lot of bites, but there's lots of ways of approaching it. It's all about getting the lines right, getting the equipment right, and being able to deal with the situations on these big wild waters. So let's take a look at my bait, let's take a look at the tackle, and hopefully give you a few tips to catch fish on these sort of venues. So when you come to these sort of venues, there's a little bit of a toss up with baits, you know, because I want to say you've got to keep your bait tray simple. I'm always a big advocate of that, but I don't really know in which direction to go today because it's my first visit here. Of course, there is the traditional route. So baits like casters, maggots, worms, these sort of baits catch fish wherever you go. So I won't ever go fishing anywhere without these baits. However, a lot of these big waters, they see a lot of pellets and corn and fish meal ground bait. So I've had to cover that base as well. So you can see here on my side tray, I've got some pellets and corn, and I've got some casters, maggots, and worms. Now, the two ground baits I've got are quite interesting as well. Again, I wasn't sure what to go with. I've heard a little bit of what people fish, but I always like to make my own mind up. So first of all, I've gone with what we call a sort of a sweet, traditionally type mix, which is hemp based, and it's the black roach from Sonu Baits. Now, I have put a little bit of F1 Dark in this because I do really like that ground bait, just to help thin my mix out a little bit, make it a bit more feeder friendly. That's a fantastic ground bait, that black roach. It's really good for pole, but I do want to make sure the bait comes out of my feeder, so that F1 black's going to help that. And you can see it's nice and dark, very hempy, and I can use this to target roach, pommies, those sort of fish. Now, on the other hand, I've gone with something super fish mealy, and this is 50-50 green and Thatcher's, and I'm using those in equal parts, and it's made a fantastic mix. Really smelly, really fish mealy, ground up pellets in there, all different types, really, really strong mix. And this is what I'm going to use on the longer line today because I want to target slightly bigger fish. And that leads me nicely onto my two lines. So when I come to a venue like this, I always like to look at two different lines to fish. First of all, I want to try and fish as long as possible in the conditions that I've got. Now, for me, that means over 60 meters. I need to be over 60 meters. And it sounds like, why are you going that far? Because actually here today, it doesn't really get a lot deeper at that sort of distance. However, my feelings are that a lot of these bigger fish do just sit out in the reservoir, so I want to cover a distance that bit further out. I also want to look at a line closer in where I can catch smaller fish a lot quicker. If I go out on the long line and I'm just catching small fish, I'd love to be able to catch them at half the distance. So for me today, I've clipped up the 4 meter distance master at 66 meters. Okay, I've got braid on the reel. I've got a nice big reel in there in the extremity 620. So I'm going to be able to chuck out there. No problem today. The wind's light, slightly across me. It's not in my face or anything else. So 66 meters shouldn't be a problem, which is always my consideration. I could go say 70, 75, but if conditions get bad, then I might be struggling. So don't want to go too crazy on that. And then I've clipped up an 11 foot Monster X with the 520 centrus and braid at 30 meters. Now this is a really, really nice rod. tippy at the top, so I can see all the indications and I can make contact with the fish, and I've got plenty of power in the lower bit if I need to chuck a heavier feeder or anything like that. So a nice combination that gives me a 30 meter line and one at 66. And I'm gonna target those slightly differently with my baits. So looking at the baits, I'm thinking in my mind, on that longer line, I need to think more big fish minded. Pellets, corn, and fish meal ground bait. That's the main focus of my attentions today. I've got some casters and I am gonna put a few in there as well to start off with. Notice there's no worms in that mix. Nothing that I think is gonna draw any small fish in, just to begin with. And then on the closer line, I'll probably put two or three feeders in with some worms, with the roachy mix, maybe an odd caster in there, just as a more open mix to attract everything possible in there. And I'll probably, after feeding this long line at the start, start on the shorter line and see if I can get that going with a few fish. Let's take a closer look at the gear I'm going to use at the terminal end. So we need to talk a little bit about the feeders that we're going to use on these lines. Now, we all know when you're fishing at distance, you need feeders with the weight down. Winder feeders, bullet feeders, these sort of feeders. Now, these new bullet feeders are absolutely fantastic. The weight is all compact at the bottom. There's a lovely little gradient here just off the bottom of the cage, which allows the bait to flush out of the feeder really easily. And this is a nice big six square. And this is what I'm going to use at the start of the session. So I'm going to take a handful of the ground bait, put it in this tub, a handful of the pellets, and a handful of the corn. So I've taken an even amount of each, and I'm just mixing them all together there, and that will go really nicely in this feeder, and I'm gonna put that in 10 times at the start. Now, I could use something bigger, a bigger rod and all the rest of it, but I really wanna be accurate. And with a bullet weight like this, these fly like an absolute missile, and I can be as accurate as possible with those 10 casts. And it's gonna create a bit of disturbance, a bit of activity, and put some fish in the peg. So this sort of feeder is really, really important. Once I get fishing, I might drop it down a little bit, but having that cage nice and open and exposed, especially in the shallow water, is gonna be the perfect feeder for today. Let's take a little look at this shorter line now, because it's not quite as straightforward as putting a bullet feeder or a winder feeder on there, because there is advantages of using a more traditional style side-loaded cage feeder. Now, these wire cages are made from the same sort of wire as the bullet feeders. They're very, very strong, and the lead is on the side. Now, this is obviously how we traditionally fish with feeders, and one of the big advantages of this being open is I can scoop it into the ground bait really quickly, fill it up with the mix I need, and get fishing. So when you're trying to be really efficient in and out for small fish, it's a big advantage to use this sort of feeder. They also come back really well because they're completely open, they soon come up to the top, and you can wind them in really quickly, and it helps when you're catching big bags of fish. They're only really good, to be honest, up to about 30, 35 meters. Any further than that, and I'm always looking for the bullet window style feeder because I need the lead down to cast accurately at distance. But when I'm fishing shorter, I will use this sort of feeder. Now today, after I've put those 10 feederfuls in long, I'm just gonna start fishing on the short line. I'm gonna use this in about 20 to 30 gram. I haven't quite decided yet. I'm gonna see the conditions in a five square. That'll allow me to introduce some bait, probably some finely chopped worms, really quickly into the peg. 3, 4, 5 chucks, all probably only about 90 seconds long. And then I'll look to change. Now, if the fishing's really good and I'm in and out all the time, then I'll probably put the smallest, the 3 square on. Really nice little feeder here. Again, nice and wide to fill up and empty really quickly. I think that's so important. But if I'm casting in and probably waiting 2 minutes or so for bites, I'll probably stick with a 4 square. Again, nice and wide and open, but it just introduces that bit more bait because I'm waiting longer for bites. So you can see there's some decisions to be made here, but I'm going with the wire cages short and the bullet feeders long. That's my choices for today, and I think they're gonna be perfect for this reservoir, to be honest. So we've fed the bait on the long line, and just put in there, like we talked about, corn and pellets and a little bit of ground bait. Just gonna leave that for sort of half an hour or so and just see what the situation is on this shorter line. Now I've chopped up a couple of potfuls of worm, really nice and fine this worm, nice and fine. So obviously I'm thinking about everything in mind. I've just put a couple of handfuls of the roach sort of all round ground bait in a tub. I'm gonna put a nice handful of the worm and just a few, not loads, of casters in there. Just a bit of a sort of sample hook bait, if you like, for them to look at. And just give that a whiz round. And this is probably only enough in here to fish for up to an hour. And it's just, because I'm gonna be fishing in and out all the time, I usually like to blob my bait in and do it as I go. But when I'm fishing rapidly like this, I wanna be able to introduce bait quite quickly. So just gonna put a little bit more ground bait in there. That's lovely. So there's plenty of worm in there. There's plenty of caster in there. You can see there, it just looks really nice. Odd caster, nice fine bits of worm and some ground bait. Now, like I mentioned before, I've got the five square on, no hook length on just to start with. I'm just gonna have two or three really quick chucks where I've just barely nipped that in the feeder at all. Literally just one squeeze and then, there it is. Just to empty it out dead quickly. Got a bit carried away myself there. Tried to cast it too hard, didn't I, hey? Tighten my clutch up. So I've emptied it out dead quickly and I'm just gonna do three of those with this five square, which puts a little bit of cloud in the water, a little bit of bait in the water. Again, barely nipping that in there. Just enough for it to nip in the cage nicely. A bit more gentle this time. There we go, lovely. Not gonna wait, I'm just gonna literally give that a little shake. And that's hopefully putting a little cloud of bits of worm and casters and that in the water. And if there is any small fish available or any fish where I can get some quick bites, hopefully they'll come straight into it. And that's why I'm just doing the three quickly and then I'll pop the hook length on. So last one, again, just barely squeezed, no rush whatsoever. Perfect. Got braid on this reel as well, a shock leader on. And that's one of the reasons I like to use this particular type of rod. You can see there, soft at the top and then a little bit of strength at the bottom. It's perfect for casting like this five square, 30 grammer out. Now I'm gonna drop down, I'm gonna put that four square on, I think, just to start with. There we go. Oh. Dig it out. Pop that on there, 30 gram again. And hook length wise, I'm just gonna put a 14 on to begin with and an N20. Really like these hooks for this style of fishing. And I've got that tied to actually some 013 reflow power there tied to today. And I'm gonna start nice and short, just literally a 50 centimeter hook length. I wanna see if there's any fish there. I really don't know what's gonna happen today. I don't know if we're gonna get bites straight away or not. Hopefully we will do. I always just tie my hook lengths. You're probably wondering what I did there. I just tie my hook lengths to a meter or just over a meter and it allows me to cut them down to the length I need. Just keep them in, keep the excess line in a little tub there. And I can use any length I need. I can just measure it off against my side tray then, you see. So there we go. Starting hook bait, what we're gonna go for? I think you can't go far wrong on a single red maggot. So we're gonna go for a single red maggot to start with. Hooks are razor sharp, you can just feel the bait going straight away. They've got a nice barb on them there, so fish are gonna stay on. And I've just gone with it really tightly to start with. I might add a little paternoster onto there at the moment, just one of the traditional sliding type rigs, but we'll see how we get on. Light little squeeze, a little bit firmer this time because I'm not emptying it straight away. Let's see what happens. Now, I've got my rod rest set up, my butt rest set up, should I say. And the idea is that I would fish with my butt rest when I'm sitting waiting for bites. So when I'm expecting to wait long times for bites, well, not even anything over about 2 minutes, really, I put my rod on the butt rest. But because I'm not, I don't want to be waiting a long time on this line. This line is purely to hopefully get some bites. I'm just tweaking my braid on my reel just to tighten it up. Not an indication just yet. I'm not gonna wait too long. I don't need a stopwatch for this line because if I wasn't talking to you, I'd just be counting roughly to about 50 seconds, something like that. I'm expecting all my bites to come quickly on this line. And if they don't come quickly on this line, then it's no problem because I'll be casting in regularly, you see, and building a swim. And that's the idea. Sometimes with small fish, it can take 20, 30 minutes in order to build some activity there, in and out all the time. You know, I haven't had a bite now. Let's pick this up. Oh, little fish on the end. Look at that. Never even saw a bite. So a nice start. There's actually one on. That's good. Hence why it's never a bad thing to pick up after 50 seconds. Not going to say to you I saw the bite because I just didn't. Come off there. Typical. It's nice and smooth. Even come off and gave me a tangle. Look at that. You can't write that down, can you? There we go. Let's just untangle that. Lovely. So maggot's been obliterated. Let's try again. So same thing again. Just gonna fill that feeder up nice and lightly there. Not gonna nip it in too firm, but just firm enough that I sort of imagine it getting down to the bottom before it breaks up. When I was feeding that bait beforehand, I wasn't thinking about the bait breaking up. That's lovely. Just follow the feeder down. When I was feeding those five squares, I barely squeezed the ground bait in, but now I'm just squeezing it in a bit tighter, just because I've had that little introduction. I'm gonna see what happens and just gently tweaking my braid all the time with my rod, looking for little shudders, looking for little indications on that braid. Any sign that there might be a fish there? I'm going to repeat this process, like I said, for probably about 20 minutes. I don't think it's going to do me any harm on the long line, just leaving all that bait I've introduced. Just leaving that bait in the peg will give the fish a chance to come and settle over it. And in the meantime, I'll be building up a peg short. Now, obviously, we might not catch anything. They might not come in those 20 minutes, but we haven't done it any harm because in that 20 minutes, I'm gonna have probably in and around 15 or 20 casts. So that will introduce a volume of bait also to the short line and give the longer line a bit of a time to settle down. So this is a little bit of a welcome turn up for the books. I think this is the third cast, and this is not a tiny roach. It's definitely a better fish. You know, I was really on the quick chucks there as well. But it just goes to show you never know. You know, it might be that we might be really lucky and be able to catch all the fish at this closer distance today. I mean, this feels a bit breamy, if I'm being honest, so we shall see. I'm going to take it steady. I've got a decent hook on and decent line, so I shouldn't have any massive problems, he says. But what a welcome bonus this will be if this is a big fish at 30 metres. It is as well. It's a bream. Get in. It's a bream. Brilliant. Gone a little bit overcast, probably not done us any harm at all. Look at this, bream close. Oh, I tell you what, not even a small one. Come on, baby, come see me. Well, so what I've taught you there is roach mix and worms and a few casters have worked for the bigger fish. Can you believe that? Everything that we've done for the bigger fish further out, and then we've had a response like that close in, and I'll tell you what, that is a proper fish as well. Look at the state of that. Well, that's here surprised even me. Single maggot hooked perfectly in the bottom lip, and he's obviously there, and there's a chance on a day like today, you never know, it could be that there's a load of those there. I'm actually not going to change anything just yet. I don't see any reason to change. I might put two maggots on this cast, but obviously the fish has come to that bait that I've fed, so there's no reason to be making a major wholesale change just yet. We had a small fish on the first cast, and when I never had an indication on the second, I was a bit worried, but maybe those bigger fish have just moved in straight away. So let's have another little chuck out with this and see how we get on. What a welcome bonus that is. I'm really chuffed with that. A pleasant surprise. Right. Oh, small fish indication straight away that time. You know, it could just be that one or two bream came into the peg and just pushed the small fish straight out. That's a small fish. It's not a tiny fish, but it's a smaller fish. Flipping egg, what absolutely fantastic fish. We've only just started, I can't believe it, to be honest. You know, usually on these big reservoirs, you expect a long time to get bites, but you know, this is straight away. And at 30 meters, which is nice, because it, you know, it does give you an opportunity to build on your day and maybe catch quickly. You know, really a nice, I do know that they've been catching nice mixed bags here, so I was hoping for some bites, but skimmer this one. Nice one. We'll take him. Might have to rename the old black roach groundbait if it continues like this. Look at that, fantastic, on the wire cage. There you go, look, probably a pound, I'd say. Really thick set fish that was. I think we're gonna have to stick with the old double maggot for now. No reason to change, is there? Again, I've just got that mix there, so I'm just gonna keep with this mix for now. I don't see any reason to introduce any more bait. You know, there's obviously a few fish there. They're coming into what I'm feeding, so let's just stick with that for the time being. There's no reason to change. That's beautiful. It's not very deep there where I'm fishing. I would guess at about 6 or 7 foot. It's not what I would call traditionally, you know, on these big reservoirs, a deep area. Like I say, I know that this was an area that there has been a few fish, so we'll have to see. Now, obviously in my mind, obviously those two bites have come quite quickly. But in my mind now, I'm thinking, you know, maybe I need to give this a little bit longer per cast because there is some bigger fish there or better quality fish there. Maybe I don't need to wind in every 50 seconds. You know, if I don't get one this chuck, that's more like what we were after. I think it's a small roach or something, or something smaller, maybe a little pommy or something. What fantastic fishing. What a fantastic place to be fishing, unbelievable. This rod is working absolutely perfectly, you know, as well, because 30 meters is a funny little distance. You can see it's more than soft enough to deal with everything I've got here. What we got? A perch. We'll net him anyway, a perch. Right, we're off and running. So obviously that longer line might hold a few more bigger fish, which is what we need, but again, like I said to you before, it's not going to do any harm just leaving it for 15-20 minutes. We'll see the sort of reaction we get. We'll work on this line for a little while now and I'll come back to you and tell you what I'm thinking, whether we need to change or go from there. But what an absolutely brilliant start. Let's see what happens. Well, you saw me catch the bream. and the little fish plan isn't going to plan at 30 meters, and that's mainly because we're absolutely and utterly full of proper fish. It has been one of the most unbelievable starts to a fishing session in my entire life. I've had big perch, skimmers, a big hybrid, we've had that big bream. All the fish are so unbelievably fit. Within 4 or 5 casts, I realized that I needed to be a lot more manned up. So we've put the size 10 N20. Look at that. Right, the size 10 N20 on. These fish don't care. They're so strong. It's unbelievable. They're so thick across the back. And look at that. He wasn't ready, was he? Got him in a bit quick. You can tell by the positive way they're taking the bait. Look there, a good, he looks probably 2 pound to you, but I can tell you now, look how thick he is there. He's gonna be 3 pound, that fish has. And it's just unbelievable fishing. I mean, I'm fishing 30 meters, still on the distance cage. I've changed the mix a little bit. I've chucked in a big handful of corn. I've chucked in an extra handful of casters. I'm very aware of the fact that there's a lot of fish there feeding. I've changed my bait as well from 2 maggots. So what I've done is I've just literally hooking the top of a worm and nipping it off about an inch or so down. A bigger piece has been good as well. Filling the feeder with one squeeze, not too tight. I just want the bait to come out pretty quickly, to be honest. And then a nice little cast of 30 meters. And it is absolutely and utterly insane. You know, I really wasn't expecting this. Wasn't expecting it to be anything like this. I was hoping for small fish short. You can just see there, I'm tightening up the tip. I've just made my rig into a little free running sort of paternoster style, just so the fish can hook themselves a bit nicer. That's been nice, just a little link in there as well. And we're not having to wait long for bites at all. I mean, curse of the camera, you never know, but you can see on that last cast, I mean, that was a 3 pound fish within a minute of the feeder hitting the bottom. Crazy, really. So the little fish plan is out the window. Now I'm thinking to myself, well, we can have some fantastic fishing here. And if they go from this line, obviously we've still got the option of moving out onto the longer line. It just goes to show that going in on a shorter line just to see what's there can really pay dividends on these water. You just don't know what's going to happen. There we go, look at that. That's got to be on, isn't it? A small fish. Might have just come off there, not really too sure. Very small, whatever it was. I haven't really had many of them. In fact, I'd say the smallest fish I've had is attached yet. Did just come off, was just a small perch, but we'll have another chuck in again. I'm sure we won't have to wait too long, but just a crazy turn of events. And you know, sometimes we get lost in a distance feeder or whatever it is, and the good old four square cage is just performing massively well today. And if they were further out, we'd have to fish with the heavier tackle. That one did not take long at all. We are right in the flight path of East Midlands Airport here, so I do apologise for an odd plane that goes overhead, but I don't think we can wait for those today. There's that many fish. You can see there, that was in the water for no time whatsoever. Here he comes. This is just fantastic. Honestly, I cannot remember a day like this. You know, we've only been fishing 30 or 40 minutes maximum, and I'd say we're probably up to 20 pound already. It's been that sort of crazy start. I mean, and mainly small fish, apart from the big bream to start with, these sort of pound and a half, 2 pounders are what we've been catching. But it has been, I'm not even going to change my worm. That's how aggressive I think it can be. just has been some bites so unbelievably quickly. So just gonna nip that in a bit nicer there. Like I said, it's worth putting all that corn and, you know, I can afford to give them a little bit of bait now. Just do a bit of maneuvering around the media team. It's tight. I've just had a liner there as well. I mean, that, to be fair, that was the first liner I've had, which surprised me a little bit, because you'd think that there'd be that many fish there, you would be getting liner to death, but I haven't really had that many liners so far. I am being patient as well. When I'm getting the rattles on the tip, I'm sort of like ignoring them, unless I think that's on, which is only an extra 2 or 3 seconds, because I'm not really interested in too much picking up on the small fish. This is just feels like a perch or something this time, but I'd take my time a little bit. I'm not, you know, if we put every fish in the net, you know, we've got a size 10 hook on, so I don't have to play them as such, but just a nice steady wind, get them sort of coming towards me, and I'm more than happy, to be honest. What's this gonna be? I'm saying a nice perch or something this time. Ooh. Tell you what, he's not very happy about being hooked. Oh, a roach! Look at that, I haven't had a roach yet. What a roach as well. What an absolute beauty, look at that. What a day's fishing. I can't believe the first time I've been here. Absolutely and utterly fantastic. Fantastic. So, that was the intended quarry, wasn't it? What we started for, those sort of smaller fish. It's taken me 40 minutes to catch one. I've just been pestered by 20 plus pound of skimmers and breams to start with first. So, just again using that same mix, there's no need for me to do anything like add baits at a time. There's clearly a lot of fish there, so I can just use the ground bait. That's going in lovely, that is. Just like that sink. I mean, there's indications almost immediately. Sometimes you know, you've seen it already, it's gone round within 10 seconds. But often it's, you know, I've sort of got a minute. Oh, nice liner there. Yeah, there's fish there now. I mean, that is crazy. Are you on? Just want to be patient, you know. I want to make sure that I come back with one. You know, I know there's a lot of fish there. I've got a worm on, it's quite durable. What brilliant fishing. And we've got him. Yeah, feels like a bream, that one. Amazing. Amazing. This rod is absolutely fantastic for this fishing, you know. It's got the perfect bend. It doesn't give under pressure. It's soft enough to cushion all the lunges. It's just absolutely great. This, you know, everything that I'm fishing with today, I've got such confidence in. Flipping heck, it's coming towards me like a flipping whale to the, just all the water's parting. I think it fancies taking me on, this fish. Whoa. Look at that, what a cracking bream. What a cracking bream. Well, I'm gonna enjoy a bit of this fishing for a while. There's been some very, very nice tips there. We'll have a look at that longer line in a minute, shall we? Just to see how we can go out there. But wow, what fishing, huh? Big open Staunton Arrow Reservoir. Incredible. Okay, so amazingly, the short line has actually dried up a bit. We got a good hour and 20 out of it, but then it just looked to me like few casts, no indications, and to put three or four bigger 5 square cages in. I'm gonna go back out on this long line now, or have a go on this long line, should I say. Personally, I think all that bait there is probably gone now, so I'm gonna put the 6 square bullet feeder on again. I've got 60 grand because I really just wanna get there. Don't want any problems or anything like that. If I can drop it down a little bit, I might do to a 50, but I'm gonna start with a 60 and we'll see if there's any fish there. So this is my first cast back out there. Absolutely no idea what's gonna happen, but it'll be very interesting to see. Obviously, picking up a bigger rod is quite difficult as well. It's quite difficult when you've been fishing with a short rod to then go and pick up a significantly bigger rod, I always find, and just needs to be a little bit slower but powerful. It's quite a strange casting technique, or the difference in casting technique, but it's obviously a nice challenge all the time. I'm just gonna bring my rod rest into play. When I'm fishing at distance, I am hopefully hoping for bream. I've got the initial mix that I used, and I've just put a few worms in it because we've caught bigger fish and there's been no signs of little fish. What I've done is that pellets, corn and fish meal ground bait combination. I've just brought that into the bowl and then put a nice big handful of worms, chop worm, into it, because it does seem like the worms are attracting fish. So let's just see, as I've just had an indication there, I think there might be one on. What is this place all about? This is absolutely ridiculous. That's my first cast back out there, no bait for an hour and a half, and it feels to me like a significant fish. I didn't mess about with hooks. In the interest of fairness, I put an N30 on this time, but again in a size 10, 015. The old 4 meter distance master, and just wanna try and sort of get him coming towards me really, nice sort of steady wind if I can. Got him coming now. That's a bream as well. That's unbelievable. Honestly, no cast there, nothing since that initial 10 feeder falls. And obviously there's just been a few bream and they've just potentially backed off from that 30 meter line. So it'd be nice if we could put a few together here as well. It's always nice to mix it up. And on the waters that you fish, it might be that this longer line is where the bream sit. I mean, there's no real difference in depth between these 2 meters to two lines today, so I'm not particularly sure. That rod's working so well. That's fantastic. Got him coming now. A bream first chuck. What a result. crazy fishing. Crazy. Oh yes, it's a proper fish as well. There we go. What a way to start. That is absolutely fantastic. Like I said, I've not had a chuck there. That is the first cast. Look at that. That's the biggest fish of the day. Real stonking fish. I can barely get my hand around it. I reckon that's 5 pound every ounce. Really, really nice fish. Just nailed in there. Oh, what a fish. I'm going to pop him in via the net. He's that big. Oh, fantastic. So maybe there's going to be a few bream out there on that more fish mealy bait, that corny pellety bait. I'm even going to add an extra handful of pellets into the mix there on that. Confident, get a few worms and just sort of mix them. I'm not going to go crazy with the worm, because I'm not sure it's the worm that they're coming to. They definitely like to eat the worm, but I don't want to put loads in. So I've got, you know, usually I like to add the bait as I go, but I'm just not feeling it for this place. I'm feeling that this is a place where I can just be really positive with my mix. Just thread that piece of worm on again. Like I say, I've just an inch and a half piece of worm. Keep with this big feeder. I think there's, you know, why not? I don't think they're backing off the feed. I don't think it's the feed they're backing off from. So we'll stick with the big feeder for now. See what happens. You notice I'm just standing up to cast. Just trying to give myself as much space as possible, and then I can comfortably hit the distance. I mean, 66 meters is not, you know, it's not an easy cast. It's not, but when you've got the right tackle, it, you know, and you get into a rhythm, it isn't posing a big challenge, so. I'm already really interested in this place. Like, I'm thinking, when can I get on? When have I got the opportunity to come and fish some competitions here? Because, you know, there's obviously different fish. It's not just bream, there's skimmers. We've had some big roach today, hybrids, loads of perch. There's a lot of fish. And you're gonna have to work to try and figure out what's the best for your peg at a given time, but. I'm going to put a few casters in that mix as well. I'm just really hedging my bets with feed. Keeping everything mixed. I'll show this to the camera now while we're waiting for a bite. You can see there, I've got an unbelievable mix of bait. Loads of bait in there. Loads of big particles in there. Bits of worm, pellets, corn, casters. You know, there's lots of bait there for the fish to eat. And on this sort of venue, I think in particular, that's what you need. You need, you know, baits that the fish can really get at and settle down. No real indications this chuck, which is interesting. And, you know, it might just be that there was a, you know, the water's clear, it's relatively shallow. When a feeder crashes in a few times, maybe the bream don't like it, which is why we caught one first cast. We shall see. You know, if it doesn't really happen here within a short period of time for any amount of fish, I'll be keen to come back on the short line. There's a fish on there. Snag again. It's a little bit snaggy out there, weed or rocks or something like that, but I managed to get it over it. Excuse me, I think you noticed I was a lot more positive there as I hooked the fish, and it was a good job too, because in the same position I did come across that snag, so I've just got to be aware of that now in my fishing. This is why on these big waters you do need to be thinking big hooks. You know, there's a lot of snags, we've got heavy rods, we've got big feeders on. You know, the fish aren't hook shy, so why not give yourself the best chance when you hook a fish? Made a huge difference. I mean, these bullet feeders, that is just absolutely soaring out there without even trying, so it's just what you need. You know, it's the perfect feeder choice for that distance, so just like that cage worked lovely in close. Oh. Nice big perch. Never say no to one of those, do you? Look at that. Just fantastic fishing. Obviously the clear water allows you to have all the colours. Look at that. What a fish. What a fish. He's had the bait and he's on for a while, but we've got him straight away, which is a really good sign. Right, I'm going to get back and do a little bit of fishing and we'll see how we finish up. Hopefully catch a few more. Well, decided to make a little bit of a change. Bullet feed has been really nice. It's definitely drawn some fish into my peg, but I'm getting a few indications and I feel like these fish need a bit more bait in order to stay in my peg. It's almost like the cage has worked well with the ground bait and drawn them there, but now I really do want some bait. So I've put on an extra large window feeder. Now this is in 60 grams and the capacity of this feeder is massive. All right, a lot of bait in there. It's probably a similar capacity to that cage feeder, but I can fill it full of bait. So all I've been doing is a scoop of casters, corn, pellets and worms, and then smearing a little bit of ground bait at the front. So the whole feeder is absolutely rammed full of bait and just a tiny bit of ground bait at the front. And I've had three casts now, and on my last cast I had a bream, and on the cast before that I had a big skimmer. I've got a feeling these fish are gonna really settle down onto some bait now. And I think making that change is gonna make a big difference. Obviously, it's still a weight down feeder. It's absolutely cast like a missile, hits the clip no problem. That's again 60 grams, so it's not any lighter than what I've been fishing or anything like that, but it's just a bait carrier. And I do think that's gonna really help these fish settle. And what I have noticed is the fish I'm catching out here are bream. They're not the mixed fish I was catching closer in. So I was catching a lot of nice skimmers, sort of a pound, pound and a half, maybe 2 pound, and an odd bream. Here I'm getting a very odd skimmer, a very odd perch, but most of the fish are proper bream, like 4, 5 and even 6 pounds. So I really do feel like this change to this window is going to make a huge difference, and hopefully we'll keep catching a few more, and then unfortunately probably have to call it a day, but let's see. I'm sure that this is going to make a big difference, and having that versatility in the feeders really can help you put that big bag together. Well, I'm calling this the last one of the day, reluctantly. 5 or 6 pound. Incredible change, switching to that window feeder late on for these fish. You know, what a day we've had. Short, we caught really nicely. Skimmers, odd bream. And then we went long, caught a few bream, and then really settled them down when we've changed to this large window feeder. I mean, that fish is just absolutely huge. Look at that. Pop that down there, see if you can get a look at him. Needs 2 hands to get around him. How are they gonna get bream with 2 hands to get around him? Look at that. What an absolutely cracking day at Staunton Howe Reservoir. Thank you very much. What a day. I am absolutely made up. I hope you've had some great tips for big open reservoirs like this. Well, join me on the bank again soon, no doubt. Hopefully for another day like this. Yeah.